Hi, welcome to an Arduino step-by-step course by Robojax. This is for absolute beginners. You just need to have a development board and also some components that is needed for that lecture. And you need to have a PC or Mac to start learning Arduino. Hi, in this lecture we are going to learn about number system and bases. The numbers that we use in our financial calculation and daily transactions is based on a decimal or base 10. So numbers are represented in different ways. For example, our decimal number, which is base 10, every 10 the numbers increase or change or increment. We go from 0 to 9, and after that, when it reaches 10, we go to the next place value. For example, these 5, 3, or 299, these are decimal number. And then we have base 2 or binary. Binary mean 2 in two ways or two position. So we have either 0 or 1. Any number you want to represent, we will use 0 and 1. For example, 10100 is one value or a number, or 101 is another. So you have no choice of using other values, because all the calculation in computer and storage and actual calculations are done based on binary because of simplicity, 0 and 1. And then we have hexadecimal. Decimal, we said, is referring to 10, and hex means 6. So that is 6 on top of 10, that is 16. That's why we call it base 16 or hexadecimal. Hexadecimal goes from 0 to 9, and after that A, B, C, D, it goes up to F. And here A to E is a number, which I'm going to explain all of those. And then 14BD is also another number. This is a hexadecimal number. And then we have octal. Octal means 8, and that's base 8. And the number starts from 0 to 8, and after 8, it increments back to 0 and up to 8. 8 in 8, base 8 is an 8, and 5, and then 14. This 14 is not equivalent of our own 14 decimal, which I'm going to show you how you can calculate that. We will start explaining with the base 10, which we use. This is a decimal, and for example, when we write 245 in decimal, how we have determined the value of this? Actually, we have, this is the first place of value, this is the second place of value, and this is the third one. And this number goes from 0 to 9, which is 10 different values. And after that, because it's repeating, we have to add here one more and then continue. And then when this one reaches up to 9 and this reaches 9, so it will be 99. After that, we have no more room to display. And we have no choice but to add one more, and this will be 1. So that's why we read 100. Now let's see what it means. First, the position 0, the position 1, the position 2. This 5 means, because it's base 10, put 10 and put the position at the power. And then multiply it by the value. Now any number to the power 0 is 1. That's first thing that you have to remember. And then 1 times 5, 5. So we got 5 here. Then 10 to the power, because this is a position of this one, is 1. 10 to the time to the power 1 is 10 times 4, because this is 4, that is 40. And then this is to the power 2, so 10 to the power 2 times the value is 2 times 2, that is 200. Now if we add them all together, this will be 245. That's why the value is 245. And now let's have a look at a binary or base 2. Base 2 is the same principle applies. We have 1 and 0 and 1, so this is a 101, a value, and the place or position starts from this side, position 0, position 1, position 2. Same thing, because this is base 2, we put the base as a 2 and then the position as a power. So 2 to the power 0, we said anything to the power 0 is 1, multiplied by the value 1, so we got 1 here. And then here, base 2 to the power, the position 1, that is 2 to the power 1 is 2, multiplied by 0, the value is 0. And here we have the position is 2, so base 2 to the power, the position 2, 2 to the power 2. Pay attention, this is 2 to the power 0, 2 to the power 1, 2 to the power 2, multiplied by 1, this is 4. If we add them all, we are getting 5. So this is actually 5 in decimal. And the answer, because this is in decimal, we have to show it at the lower right corner, a number either 8, 16, or 10. So this 10 means this 5 is base 10. So this is a decimal value. Now let's have a look at the octal. We have 164 or 164, but this is not decimal, this is octal base 8. The position is the same as before, is 0, 1, and 2. And let's see the value.
It goes from 0 to 7, and we don't have any other value. When this position reaches 7, we add one more here.
And if you see here, 1 and 4, then this doesn't mean 14. You will see it now. Now, this is base 8. We put 8 to the power 0. Anything to the power 0 is 1. Multiply by 4. The position is 0, so the value is 4. And here, 8 to the power 1 times 6, the value. This 1 is the position. Pay attention, 8 to the power 0, 1, and then the next one will be 2. And if we have more, we will continue. Times. So this value is 8 times 6, that is 48. And here, 8 to the power 2, 8 is 64, 8 times 8 times 1, that is 64. If we add it all together, the value is 116. You see, now we are representing a number with lower value. And this 10 means base 10, so this is 116 of decimal value. Now let's have a look at the hexadecimal or base 16. Hexadecimal, hex and decimal. And we have 2BF. The position starts from the right, 0, 1, 2. It goes this way. And we apply the same rule. But before that, we have to know some values. The number starts from 0 to 9. And then we have A, B, C, D, E, and F. And each of these letters have a value. A is 10, B is 11, and C is 12, up to F is 15. So we have to keep this in mind and then go. For example, this F means 15. Now let's see. Because this base is 16, we put the base to the power of the position, 16, anything to the power 0 is 1, times this F is 15. So this means 15. And for B, 16 to the position 1 times B. The value of B is 11, so this B is 176 at this position. And if B was here, this would have been 11. And now 2, the position of 2, so 16 to the power 2, that's a position, multiplied by 2, the value. And this is 512. Now, if we add them together, you will see that we got 703. And this is base 10. I'm using this Windows calculator, and you can open it by clicking on the start and type calculator, and from here, select programmer. It has so many other options for different purposes, but when you go for programmer, now you can see this bar on the left side of binary. We are in binary mode, and in binary we have only 0 and 1. For that reason, everything else has been disabled, and all of the numbers. So we can enter only 1 and 0. I can just do some random numbers, and it automatically calculates here the decimal value is 365, and binary is this. Now you can automatically converted to octal, so 555, and in terms of hex it's 16D. Now pay attention here, let's go for hex. When we go for hex, A, B, C, D, and F is also activated. Now if I use, pay attention here, if I use 3F, now look at the value. In terms of decimal, this is 4095. So with three values, which can occupy three spaces, we can represent a number that goes up to 4000. While 4000, you can see, occupies four spaces. So that is the beauty of hex. You can represent a larger number with smaller few characters. And if I go further, these are like that, and you can see now it's already 16 million. But binary takes huge amount of space, and this is the way that data is being processed and stored in memory. So you can play with this calculator to get the value, because in Arduino we will be using a lot of hex value and also binary values. For that reason, we need to understand this number system and bases. Please make sure to subscribe by clicking at the subscribe button in here. Thank you. Thank you for watching the tutorial from Robojax. If you learned something and found this useful, please thumb up, as this will help my video in the search algorithm of YouTube. If you have comment or question, please post it at the comment section below. I try to answer and reply. And don't forget to subscribe so you get updates of my upcoming videos.